guys. I'm Michelle Ford. I'm here at the NEF Horror Festival. I'm with Don and Anna Bees, and they are with Keep the Gaslight Burning, which is our final film that is screening this evening. So, guys, tell me a little bit about the film.
Well, it started out as a joint project between the directors, Dave and Lou Elsie, and Anna and I. And we've been friends for about 13 years, and we work in the film industry usually. And we got together for dinner one night, and we just said, let's make a movie. And Dave said, I've got a script, and we said, we can put together a crew. And 64 days later, I think it was, we were shooting it.
Wow, so. Amazing. And so tell me your roles in the film. In the creative process.
I was the producer for the film and obviously all-round collaborator with Dave and Lou and Don.
Great.
And Don was the producer and editor for the film.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And so what brought about the idea, the vision for the film?
Well, we the dinner that we were having one night, we were kind of complaining about other projects we had been on and said, I think we can do better.
Oh.
Or we could at least not do as worse, you know. So
that's great motivation.
Absolutely. Yeah. So it ended up being a showreel. You know, Dave and Lou have been wanting to direct. We've done other films, short films ourselves too, and we just wanted to do it. And they had some really good friends, Marky Post, who's in it, and Rick Baker, eight-time Academy Award-winning makeup artist, and they're kind of like, I think we could get Marky and Rick in it, and if we get Rick to play our ghost, that would be great. And he said, yeah, he'd love to. And Marky said, yeah, she'd love to. So
amazing. And so do you all have much experience in the horror genre?
I started out as a creature maker on the movie The Fly.
Wow,
with Jeff Goldblum.
That's so interesting.
That was my first film I worked on. But then I moved into, we both moved into visual effects. And so I did a lot of more genre related, more science fiction and those kinds of things. You know, Star Wars films and Indiana Jones and Pirates of the Caribbean, that sort of thing.
Wow.
Dave and Lou have a much stronger horror background because they're makeup artists.
Mm-hmm.
So they did like The Wolfman and the other movies are blanking. What other films that they worked on? I can't remember off.
That's
the
okay.
But they
and
won
so,
an Academy Award with Rick doing The Wolfman in 2010.
Oh, amazing. That must have been incredible to work with them. So tell me a little bit about the actual filming process. Where did you guys shoot? How long did it take?
We actually shot in our hometown of Petaluma, and
oh, okay.
We found in kind of a home that had been turn of the century, close
yeah,
to
1908
farmhouse that was up for sale, and so it was empty, and it was perfect for our set. So we literally took over the whole house for 4 days, and we said we just shot the film there, and it was perfect.
Amazing.
So it was a beautiful craftsman home that lent itself to kind of a gothic Victorian horror film.
Oh, so. Perfect. The stars aligned perfectly for that. And so what are your guys' plans for future film festivals after NEF Horror?
Well, we've run it. This is actually kind of coming to the end of its film festival life. As a matter of fact, it's starting. It's on Amazon Prime right now,
so
it could be seen for people that can't make it to the film
right.
festivals. This is one of the last film festivals we'll be doing. So it hasn't. It's run its course that way. So.
Thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me. I cannot wait to watch it. And best of luck to you guys tonight. I'm sure you're sticking around for the award ceremony.
Yes.
Yep, thank
absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. Yeah. It was nice meeting you both. Thank you so much
thank
for your
you.
Time and best of luck with your film.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.